Hey, what up? It's Tampa Brad, kicking it here in Asheville, North Carolina at the Grove Park Inn. And it's our last night here, and I'm super excited to be sharing with you book number 15 of my 20 books for 2020, and that is David Data's The Way of the Superior Man. And if you have not heard of this book, it's a bit of a cult classic, especially within self-development spheres that involve a lot of men. And personally, this book was one that I came across very, very, very early on in my what you call like self-development journey. And what I found in this book is that it expressed a lot of feelings that I kind of had prior to actually digging into the book. And it was like David Data was just putting the words in my mouth, or rather taking them right out of my mouth, or putting things into words that I had not been able to really express before. So what I found is that in reading the book, it helped me to connect with what it means to be a man. And it's funny, in the age that we live in, it's very easy to get disconnected from what it really means to be a man. In the year 2020, what does that really look like? So a lot of what we're having to compete with is we're having to balance the, on one hand, our biological drives and urges and things that like come natural and feel right. And then on the other hand, a lot of social conditioning is telling us, don't listen to that, and that's not a good way to live. And so a lot of people, and men especially, struggle with that kind of dichotomy of what they're being told by society at large versus what they feel is right. And so David Data does a phenomenal job in this book of basically laying out how to deal with that as a man in the common age, and how to get reconnected to what it really means to be a man. And so what he says is, if I were to sum up the whole book in one phrase or sentence, it would be that a man, the most attractive man, because a lot of the book revolves around men in terms of relating to women. What he says is, a man, the most attractive man is a man who is on his path, a man who is unshakable in what he is going to do and what his path is. And he basically says that the most attractive thing a man can do is to bring a woman along on his journey to walking his path. And it's not necessarily a journey to a goal per se. It's more of bringing a woman along for the journey of just walking her path in general. If you ask a really attractive woman who's very in touch with her feminine side, she's probably going to tell you that she doesn't necessarily want a guy of any particular, a lot of girls will say like, I have a type or whatever, but if a woman is really in touch with what she actually wants and not bought into social conditioning, which don't be deluded, a lot of women are very, very socially conditioned, which is okay, a lot of men are as well, but one that's a little broken out of that will just say that she just wants a man who is directed and who knows what he wants. And so that's what David Data basically expresses in this book. And he goes through a lot of iterations of what it means and gives a lot of examples. One that I really, really enjoyed, and I think about this a lot actually, is he gives the idea of how a man should act with his woman. And what he says is, the woman should be like, in a manner of speaking, not in a degrading way, but in a way, women can be a little all over the place. They can be emotional, they can be dragged around by their emotions, kind of like a whirlwind, which is amazing. But the woman is to be, to the man, like the squirrel around the oak tree. The chattering of the squirrel does not sway the oak tree. And so what that means is, not to say that women don't have meaningful things to say, they absolutely do, and they have amazing feedback. And there's other chapters in the book, if you were to take just that soundbite by itself, it would sound like David Data was derogatory to women, and that's not the case at all. But in terms of listening to emotions and emotional groundedness, a man has to be emotionally grounded and be able to be that solid trunk to a woman's emotional sways back and forth. Because I'm sure, you have a mother and potentially a sister or sisters or female relatives, or potentially a girlfriend, I don't know. There might be one guy who watches my videos as a girlfriend, maybe one. But just kidding, Rob, you're up. But that being said, the point is, if you've been around women, you know that they can get emotional about things. And this is just commonly known. What isn't commonly known or, I guess, discussed is the fact that the man, our job is to be the emotional grounding rod, to be the stability in the relationship, not to be swaying and kicked around back and forth by emotions like the women in our lives are, because they rely on us for our groundedness. That is the value that we bring to the table, is being emotionally grounded. It's not, you know, driving a nice car. It's not having a nice house or having a $15,000 Rolex. Those things are nice and those are nice add-ons, but really at our core, what our job to deliver as a man is to deliver emotional groundedness and a determination to stay on our path. It's, although a lot of women, and even as I'm saying this, I'm like, wow, a lot of women are not gonna like to hear this. A lot of women will say that they want to be the most important thing in a man's life. But if a woman is the most important thing in a man's life and she becomes upset or demands more and more of his time or really just becomes very difficult to deal with and the other pieces of his life start getting messed up, she will wind up dropping him for someone else who has his life in order, even if that other guy doesn't make her the most important thing in his life. What a lot of people will say they want, and this is not exclusive to women at all, men do this just as well, but a lot of times what someone says they want and what they actually want and respond to are two completely separate things. So that's extremely important to keep in mind as you're reading this book, is that it goes in the face of a lot of things that you've probably been told or taught, you know, as a young man in society. But take it on and consider it with some suspension of disbelief. Even if it seems a little hard to believe at times, put that to the side and consider it based on its face value. So the last kind of tidbit that I want to give from the book is the idea of life and death. So David Ada goes into, this is another kind of esoteric book, which I love. I mean, I get a lot of value out of esoteric books, even if they're a little weird or a little unconventional. So something that he goes into is discussing the fact that feminine energy represents life, and male energy literally represents death. So a male orgasm is boom, done. In French, I believe orgasm is short for, you know, the small death or mini death. Whereas for women, it's completely the opposite. They get more, you know, more engaged. You know, some, you know, there's obviously exceptions, but women can have multiple orgasms. It's the ability to create life. So that dichotomy is something that David Data talks about a lot in the book, and he explains all the different ways that plays out. A man, for example, and it's more masculine to like open empty spaces, whereas the more feminine side would be to fill the empty spaces with decorations or furniture or something like that. So he plays out that dichotomy in multiple situations, and I just think that you're going to get a ton of value out of going through this book, especially if you're a man. I know it's mostly guys that watch my channel, but even if you're a woman, you will get a ton of value going through this book. I actually know a couple women who have read this book, and it's helped them to better identify what they really appreciate in a guy. It's helped them to kind of narrow down what they're looking for and exclude some guys based on behavior that's not in line with what David Data basically prescribes in the book. So, in a nutshell, how-to guide on how to be a man, and it's extremely valuable. You're really gonna get a lot of value out of this one. It's one that I go back to again and again, you know, multiple times, probably like once or twice a year I'll go back through this book, just because it's such a poignant reminder of the things that I'm supposed to be doing and the mindset that I should be taking into my life as a man who wants to be on his path. So that being said, I want to know what you get out of this book. You know, if you're a friend of mine, if you're just like an acquaintance, if you're someone I don't know, especially if you're a client, hit me up on Instagram. My Instagram handle is @TampaBrad. Follow me there and shoot me a DM. I only have like 1,000 followers, so I respond to all my DMs. It's cool. And then also hit the subscribe button to the channel, and then hit the bell next to it. If you don't hit the bell, you're not going to get notified of when I'm dropping new videos. You're not going to see them. They're going to get drowned out in the sea of YouTube subscriber feed stuff that's going on. You know, divorces, Jake Paul, Tenement O, blah, 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 all that stuff. So I look forward to seeing the next video. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to get back to maybe drinking some hot chocolate by the fire here, because it is, I'll tell you, the Omni Grove Park Inn in Asheville, where we're staying right now, one of the most amazing hotels I've ever been at in my life. The spa is killer. So thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next vid. Appreciate you. Peace.